डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट चैप्टर 2, टाइप्स ऑफ हार्डवेयर। द फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज हार्डवेयर। एज वी नो, हार्डवेयर आर द फिजिकल पार्ट ऑफ द कंप्यूटर डैट वी कैन टच एंड सी। मीन्स ऑल द पार्ट्स ऑफ अ कंप्यूटर सिस्टम डैट आर विजिबल टू अस एंड वी आर एबल टू टच देम आर कॉल्ड हार्डवेयर्स। अ कंप्यूटर can consist of hardware and software. These are the pillars of a computer system, and it cannot work without its hardware and software. We can say that these are like the two faces of a coin, head and tail. Like head and tail are the two faces of coin that are complement to each other, such that hardware and software are also complement to each other. A system cannot work without any of the two. Now, types of hardware. Hardware are categorized as under processor, memory, input device, output device. Memory is the internal storage area which holds the data and instruction during processing and can also store the result permanently for future use. Now, it can be categorized in two types: main memory or primary memory and auxiliary memory or secondary memory. Now, before discussing about memory in detail, we have to discuss about the unit of memory. A computer store data and instruction in the form of binary numbers, either 0 or 1, where 0 represent off or low voltage and 1 represent on or high voltage. These numbers are called binary numbers, and each digit, either 0 or 1, is called a binary digit, or in short form it is called a bit. Internally, in computer, characters are represented by encoding system is a system of specifying binary codes for each character, such as ASCII, American Standard Code for Information Interchange, that represent a character as a group of 8 bit or a byte, or Unicode encoding system that represent a character as a group of 16 bit or 2 byte. So we can say that we measure memory in form of byte. So byte is the measuring unit of a memory, and 1 byte is equal to 8 bits. Now take an example. Suppose you have to save the word computer. Now it has 8 characters. So in ASCII encoding system, it has 8 byte. Its space is 1 byte, means 8 bits or 1 byte. But Unicode encoding system that represent each character with 2 bits, its space is 2 bytes or 16 bit. Now come to the primary memory or main memory. It is the built-in memory used to store data and instruction during the processing, and it store data and instruction on temporary basis. Means once the computer is turned off, whatever stored in primary memory can be erased. So that's why we need a secondary memory to store our work data and instruction permanently. Now it can be of two types: RAM, random access memory, and ROM, read only memory. RAM, it stores data and instruction during the execution of our work. means while we are working on a system, whatever data and instruction we use, that is stored inside, that is stored on RAM, and that can be lost when power is turned off, because RAM is volatile in nature, means temporary in nature. It can be read as well as written onto, means we can read instruction from RAM, and also we can able to write anything on RAM. It can be changed or altered as and when required, and we are able to change and alter it, means do any correction whatever data or instruction stored in RAM as and when required. Now ROM is read only memory. It contains a set of startup instruction like the BIOS setting, operating system, etc., that remain stored permanently even if power is turned off. So it is a non-volatile memory. It can only be read and used, cannot be changed or written onto. We are not able to do any correction in the data or instruction that are stored on ROM. It hold the data instruction that are helpful for the startup of our system, means for booting process of our system. So it hold the BIOS setting and the operating system that help our system to boot and perform their work. Now this is all about the memory and primary memory. Next topics we will discuss in next class. Thank you.